Hi. I'm Mary Axelm, and right now I'm doing the lab for muscle physiology. And right now I'm going to measure my standing height. So I've already got the tape measure measured up to 150 centimeters, and I'm going to put the tape on the wall for me to measure my standing height. So I've put the tape up at the wall where my standing height is. And because I already have this tape to the wall, I'm just gonna measure it from that point to that point. And hopefully I won't need a step stool for that, so. Okay. So it's 150 plus 52. 202. So my standing height is 202. Okay. And now I'm going to do the squat and hold the position for 1 second and then jump up and hit the wall as high as I can with the tape on my middle finger. So I'm going to do that right now, and then I'm going to do the squat quickly and jump and put that tape at the wall as high as I can as well. So here we go. Actually, I'm gonna turn around. Okay, so it's up there. And I'm gonna do the next one before I measure that, because I'm gonna need the stepladder. So in this one, I'm just gonna squat real quick and jump up. Oh, I'm getting sweaty. It's not sticking very well here, okay. Oh, so that one wasn't as high. Okay, so I'm going to get my step stool out and measure this. So the first one was up here. We'll start from the 150 mark and add 73. So 150 plus 73 is 203. Okay, 150 plus 73, I can't do that in my head for some reason. Okay, 150 plus 73.
Wouldn't it be
223? Thank you, my daughter. 223. Okay, so 223 with the squat held for 1 second. 1 second squat. Okay, and then the one without and the vertical jump would be less. Extra tape measure here. Okay, so that one is 70. So 150 and 70, easy. 220, right? 150 plus 70, 220. Okay, second jump. Okay, now we're supposed to do this a few more times. So I'm going to two additional times for a total of 3 trials. So here we go. I'm going to do the next one. So two more times. Move this out of the way. So make sure I have all this so I can record it. Okay. So I should probably get those tapes down. And I already got my standing height, so I'm going to take that off. Hold the squat for a second and then jump again without holding it for a second, but just go straight up. Okay. So one. Okay, there's that. this next jump. I'm just gonna do it really fast. And then there's that. So obviously the second jump is not as high as the first one. Let's measure the first one. The first one measures about 72 and a half, looks like. And then the second one measures to about 69 and a half. So 72 and a half, is that what we said?
Yeah, I think so.
Let's do that one more time just to make sure. So yeah, 72 and a half and 69 and a half. So I'll add that to the 150. I'll just do the math right now. So that's 222.5 on the first one, and 219.5 on the second one. Okay, now we're gonna do the third trial. And let's see if it gets even less. Okay. My hand's sweaty. Ah, keep forgetting to take the tape down. Should be faster, quicker. Two. Ow. Okay, I need to get up here to measure it, babe. All right, so the first one was here. Let's measure that. Sounds like 71 and a half. What is it? The second one is like 70. So 71 and a half and 70. Ooh, kept going down. Looks like 50, 220. Well, that's interesting because it went from 220, 219.5 to 220. So, okay. So now I'm going to input all this information into the maximum vertical jump height without the stretch shortening cycle in centimeters. And then, excuse me. And go ahead and put in the maximum vertical jump height with a stretch shortening cycle. And I put the standing height in the wrong place. So I will put that up there. And then I'll do my averages for that. And that is it for exercise 3, except I don't have all the information yet. I'll go ahead and put that in my lab report and you'll see that information in there. Thank you.